Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install VS Code Editor in a Windows 10 operating system. So, let's begin. Now to install VS Code Editor, you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here just simply type VS Code download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this, code.visualstudio.com. So you know, just simply click on that. This will, you know, automatically open your this Visual Studio official website. So you know, just simply scroll down a bit. Here you can see that there are some options to download Visual Studio Code. So if you are using some other operating system like Fedora, Linux or macOS, then you need to just simply click on this link. But in this video, I am going to show you how to install Visual Studio Code for Windows 10 operating system. So here I am going to, you know, simply click on this Windows to download this Visual Studio Code for Windows. This will, you know, automatically start downloading Visual Studio Code. This is just a 68.9 MB file, so you know it will gets downloaded easily. So now, as you can see, this VS Code user setup has been, you know, rightly downloaded. So you know, just simply click on the show in folder, and here you can clearly see this VS Code user setup has been, you know, rightly downloaded, and its version is 1.55.1. To install, just simply double click on it. And now, as you can see, our VS Code setup wizard has been, you know, rightly open. And here you need to just simply accept this license agreement and then just, you know, simply click on next. And here you can clearly see that this is going to be, you know, our installation destination. If you want to change your installation destination, then you need to just simply click on browse and you can change that your installation destination. But in this video, I'm going to, you know, keep this all default. And one more thing, you need to have 263.4 MB of free disk space. This is very important, guys. You need to have at least this amount of free disk space in your system. So after, you know, checking all this, just, you know, simply click on next. And then, you know, I'm not going to, you know, check this don't create a start menu because I want to, you know, create a start menu. So keep this all default and then just, you know, simply click on next. And here, just, you know, simply check this create a desktop icon so that, you know, our desktop icon gets created over here. This will, you know, help to open our VS Code at ease. And also, this is very important, you need to check this add to path. This is very important, guys, you need to check this. So, you know, after checking these two options, I am going to, you know, simply click on next and then click on install. So this will, you know, start installing your Visual Studio Code. It will take some time, maybe a minute or two. So for which, you know, I'm going to coming back once when it gets done. Yeah. So welcome back. And now, as you can see, our Visual Studio Code has been, you know, rightly installed. And it's now currently stating that whether we'd like to launch our Visual Studio Code. So for which, you know, I'm just going to check this and then just, you know, simply click on finish. This will, you know, automatically open our Visual Studio Code. And now, as you can see, our Visual Studio Code has been, you know, rightly open and its version is 1.55. Now I'll also show you how to run a simple Hello World program using this Java. So for that, simply go to file, then simply, you know, click on this new file. So, you know, this will open a new file, and here I am going to, you know, simply write a simple Hello World Java program. So class Hello World Demo. So this is our class, and then let us first save our file first so that, you know, it help to utilize this, you know, Visual Code for better. So for that, just simply go to file, click on this save as, and now inside this document we are going to, you know, simply going to click create a new folder. So let's give a Java programs. So just go inside that directory, and here I am just going to save this file as Hello World Demo.java. This is very important, and you need to save this file as .java. Now just, you know, simply click on save. So this will, you know, automatically save your file as a Hello World Demo.java, And here you can clearly see this color has been also rightly changed. So that's basically, you know, main functionality of this IDE. It is, you know, make your coding experience very much, you know, great. So that's basically, you know, use of this IDE. And now, you know, I'm just going to simply creating a main method. So public static void main string args. And now I'm just going to simply, you know, going to print hello world in our console. Now just, you know, simply save that. So, and now just, you know, simply go to our terminal, and here let us first check what are the directories that are available. So just simply type ls. And now you can clearly see that these are all the files and directories that are available. So you need to go inside this document directory. So you can clearly see that we have saved this file inside this document. So here we have this Java programs. So inside this document. So we need to, you know, simply go inside this document first. So for that, simply cd documents. So now we are basically inside this document. Then simply again click type ls. So now you can clearly see that we have this directory called Java program. So you need to go inside that directory. So cd Java programs. So now that you know we have inside this Java programs, let us first again type ls to check that which are the files that are inside this Java program. So here you can clearly see this hello world demo.java file has been, you know, rightly created over here. To run this Java file, you know, just simply type java c hello world demo dot java, then enter. This will, you know, automatically compile our, so I have this spelling mistake, sorry, system. So save that again. Now again just, you know, simply compile our file. So, you know, this will, you know, automatically compile our hello world.demo.java. So after compiling, you can, if you just again type ls, you'll see this hello world demo.class has been, you know, rightly generated. So after compiling, it will, you know, generate a class file. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just, you know, going to run this class file. So for that, just, you know, simply type java and our class file is hello world demo. So hello world demo is basically our class file. So just, you know, simply click on enter, and now you can clearly see this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown in our console. So in this way you can install Visual Studio Code in a Windows 10 operating system, and then I have also shown you how you can run a simple hello world program using Visual Studio Code. In my next video I am going to show you some very useful plugins that you can install in this Visual Studio Code. So that's a, you know, very much helpful video that's, you know, going to coming up. So for that, do subscribe our channel and also do press the bell icon so that you get notified. Now before closing up, I would also like to show you our website called geekyscript.com. In here you will see various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check our website geekyscript.com. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share with your friends. Again, thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.